Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to look at precautions, or let me say acceptable precautions for physics practical in GCE. You see, the way you're going to write down your precaution in WAEC should be different from the way you are going to write it when you are answering the same question in GCE. Because in GCE, you are not performing the experiments. The experiment has already been performed. So the only thing you need is just to give reports of the experiment that is performed. Now, how do we use the word good in expressing, in writing our precautions? Now, we have different precautions that is acceptable for electricity, mechanics, and optics. Now, let's take a look at that of electricity. You see, before I start this class, please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the notification bell to receive notification of my new videos, and also like my videos. Thanks. Now let's continue. Now we have these precautions for electricity. In electricity, we know that if you are to perform your experiment, one of the likely precautions I need to take is what? You should ensure repeated readings. You see, normally, if I'm to perform the experiment myself, we are going to ensure repeated readings. Although, please, many students make mistake of this, of ensuring repeated readings. You see, let me just brief what is here. If you are going to use this precaution that I would ensure repeated readings, please note that if you are to tabulate your readings, you have to give two values of that same reading. For example, you have to tabulate readings on coins, and you want to put in your precaution that you are ensuring repeated readings. Simply means you should have two values of current. Current I1 and current I2. Altogether, we are going to have two values of current. It simply shows that you took two different values for current. Then you can put in your precaution that I would ensure repeated readings. Now, you are using the word would, because you are not performing the experiment. You are just trying to report so that if I'm to do the experiment, this is likely this thing I'm going to ensure or take into consideration. The second one is that I would note and correct the zero error of the ammeter. That is quite important in physics. You see, if your ammeter is having zero error, it simply shows that your readings will be affected. So the best thing is, before you use any readings, before you use any instrument, we need to first check on the zero error. So you know you are not using the instrument, so the only thing you are trying to report to us that what you are going to what you would note and correct the zero error of the ammeter. Then the third one is that I would ensure tight connection, because if your connection is not well tight, you might have what wrong readings, maybe fluctuations. You might have what fluctuation of the instrument that you are using. Now the next one is I would avoid parallax error. Where do you avoid parallax error? You avoid your parallax error in ammeter. We can also avoid it in your meter room, also in voltmeter. Please note, electronic devices like your voltmeter, ammeter, you can avoid parallax error. That error simply means looking at it vertically instead of slantly. Looking at it slantly instead of vertically. So if you are performing the experiment, you are looking at it directly. That means you are looking at the instrument directly, not slantly. So that you would avoid this error. Now the next thing is, I would clean the terminals of the cell. If you don't clean the terminal of the cell before use, it might lead to maybe the cell, that normally use their primary cells. And all these primary cells, they have some kind of defect, maybe they've used them before. If they've used them before, there's likely that each of these cells might have some other or cell defects, like polarization and local action and the likes. Now, the next thing is that I would remove key plug after each reading. These are the precautions that you're expected to give us when you're performing an experiment on electricity. Any of this is acceptable altogether, because no matter the kind of question you're given in electricity, you are going to use the same precaution altogether. Now, I would remove key plug after each reading. If you don't remove the key plug after each reading, it simply shows that the battery will run down. And when the battery is running down, it simply shows your readings will be defects altogether. Now, let's look at the likely precautions, or the one that you are expected to give in mechanics. If you are performing an experiment on mechanics, we're referring to maybe you are performing an experiment on
simple harmonic motion, like let me say spring balance, equilibrium, or spring balance and the like.
Now, the first thing that you notice is that I would note and correct the zero error of protractor and stopwatch. This is, you always note this, if the experiment requires you to use a protractor and a stopwatch, then you need to note this error. So you would note and correct the zero error of a protractor and your stopwatch. Now, the second one is that I would avoid parallax error. Parallax error of the protractor. Please don't forget earlier I said you can only avoid parallax error if you are using a meter rule or you are using an electronic device. Now, we also have what I would ensure small angle of oscillation. Now, you see this small angle of oscillation, we always get that if you are performing experiments on maybe simple pendulum. You know, before you want to move it, you need to set it into oscillation. So if you set it into large oscillation, you might have error. Large oscillation might give you error. So you avoid what? You would ensure small angle. That means just put it, sit it at small angle, then leave it to perform its own oscillation. So you're going to ensure small angle of oscillation. Then the next one is I would make sure the pendulum bob did not touch the retort stand. If the pendulum bob touches the retort stand, it simply means the body will not complete the same oscillation. That means if the oscillation is between 20 oscillation, it will complete the oscillation, it will get a stop. All together. So ensure that when you are performing the experiment, it doesn't touch the retort stand. So I would ensure the pendulum bob did not touch the retort stand while oscillating. That is for mechanics. How do we now take how do we now write our precautions if you are given practicals under optics? In optics, the first thing I need to note is don't forget that I would ensure repeated readings. If you are taking two different readings, then you should write this. But if you are not taking two different readings, that you're only taking one single reading, avoid this. Because if you did this, they are going to deduct marks from you. Now, the second one is I would note and correct zero error of ruler. Please don't forget that every experiment in physics, you should note this error. The second one is I would ensure that the lens and the mirror are linearly aligned. You normally use this as this precaution if you are given question on maybe a convex lens or you are given a lens or a mirror. Whereby you are going to be having the objects, the mirror, the screen. So if you are given question under what lenses and mirror, please, this precaution is important. I would ensure that the objects, lens and mirror are linearly aligned. That means they are on a straight line. Because if they are not on a straight line, your values will be wrong. The first one is I would ensure neat tracing. We normally ensure this neat tracing only if you are performing an experiment on prism block, either rectangular prism block or triangular prism block. You should ensure this because in that case you are going to be tracing. So you would ensure niche tracing. Now the second one is that I would ensure that pins were vertically erect. It is still for the same experiment. If you are given a prism block, I'm going to ensure these two readings. Even though, you know, normally in this practical, you only need two precautions. So you can even give these two precautions if you are given something under prism block and you will be correct. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and please try to like my video and share it to people. Thanks very much.